All right, that looks like it's recording. The old GoPro's working. Hello, you awesome people, and how the heck are you? Went to Rouses today, and we got some catfish. We're going to fry up some catfish here in a second. And I'm going to use some Louisiana New Orleans-style fish fry. This stuff is good. Anything is good from Rouses. I don't care. Don't matter. Also, what else do I got over here? Over here, yonder. It's about 2 scallops. Now, I have never fried scallops before. Never eaten scallops before. But from what that say, that's a fresh wild caught from the U.S. of A. And if the sticker says it's from the U.S. of A, by God, I'm gonna believe it. Can't prove otherwise. So we're gonna empty this here like this. Also, I don't like what I done did. Ain't nothing like proper preparation when you're doing a video. I take some of these Ziploc bags, and what I don't use today from this package here, this is not a resealable package, I don't believe, so I'll just pour the rest of the contents in one of these bags. Keep it for later use. And whatnot. Been defeated by a plastic bag, ladies and gentlemen. Golly, that smells good. We just gonna pour a whole bunch of it. I ain't measuring nothing. Yep, that looks about right. My stove getting all dirty. I'll be fine. Clean it up later. Oh, by the way, when you're cooking this, may I suggest you get some Red's Wicked Apple. And we're gonna take these scallops out the bag here. Oh, we got a bag. And very gently place them into the pot there. See how gentle that was? We'll take the other one and gently put it in there as well. Whew, that smells strong. By the way, if y'all this far into the video, let me know what these scallops are. Honest to God, I have no idea what they are. I've not looked it up on the internet before making this. I was going to do it, but I said, you know what? The heck with it. So let me know what you think they are. I honestly don't know. I honestly don't care. I'm going to eat it. It comes from the ocean or the sea. I'm going to whip in it and put that on the plate. It's the plate I used for camping a couple of days ago. Enjoyed myself up in Tombsuba, Mississippi at the campground of America. That place was, I hated to leave. And every time I go up there, it breaks me to leave that place. It's so quiet in the evening and in the daytime and nighttime. All you hear is the crickets and the frogs frogging, and the people that run the place are really nice as well. Super nice people. We ended that trip because of a little storm out there in the Gulf. I didn't want to drive back through all that mess, so I cut my trip short, and I actually refunded some money. And I appreciate that, because they're good people. So if you're ever down, camping down on the coast, it's all right. So if you ever come down to Biloxi or Gulfport, you find some sites on the coast that you can go camping, but you're going to hear a lot of traffic noise. And I cannot stand having all that noise. You go out to Tombsuba, Mississippi, in that campground of America, you don't hear nothing. No car noise, no, what I plan on doing is also trying to find me a little boat I'd like to take out to Deer Island and do some camping out there. It's quiet at night too. It's just far enough off the coast that you can get there by kayak. I can get there by kayak, but I don't know how many trips it'd take me to take all my stuff out there. I may see if I can rent somebody's boat and get out there to that island, because that's talking about peaceful out there as well. You could take some bug spray, some off. Man, there's some damn super bugs down here. I'm just not talking about mosquitoes. I'm talking about damn deer flies and horse flies. Boy, they just... Good Lord. Talk about tightening up. Them things show you no mercy. All right, we get on in there. That's good. Perfect. If I knew what I was doing, I'd be dangerous. Ain't that pretty? So far, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Let me know.
My fryer at?
I done had this fryer here for about 5,000 years. And it worked good. I'll be telling you where it worked even better.
Preparation is the key to making good YouTube videos.
I wouldn't know about that. Come on. It's just a top. Get on in there now. Pour some Earl in there. That's Crisco Earl. Hello there, Crisco Earl. Pure vegetable Earl. I don't know the difference between all these different kinds of Earl. I just know I put it in a frying pan and cook it up. And I forgot I had this. Let me turn that on a little bit, warm that up. What that's supposed to be? I supposed to believe around 350 degrees Fahrenheit. We're gonna set it at 350. Can beat this thing to death. Get on in there and make me mad. Damn, my phone falling. Them scallops shouldn't take too long to cook. That's small. What the hell am I using that for? Jeff, tighten up. May not have enough to do all this. Running out of Earl. May I go out to my truck. Get some Earl from my truck. I don't think that'd be the proper Earl to put. Getting warm. Hope I don't burn on my GoPro. Get me another one if I did. Get on in now. Heat on up to 350,000 degrees. Yeah, we is back, and you know what? I had an idea of changing my, because my GoPro setup right now, my GoPro camera is directly over this Earl that's about 400 degrees, but I'm going to leave it there, and right now I got my hand on it, so if it falls, I don't have a burn-up GoPro and a burn-up house. That would suck. I'm just saying. We're going to put these scallops in there, burn them up a little bit. Ooh, yeah.
all about preparation, my friends, ladies and gentlemen. Which is something I ain't good at, evidently. And that same plate we have, we're gonna put a little piece of paper, hand washing, hand wiping utensil stuff thingy on there to make it get all the grease and oil off of it. I'm gonna put in a screenshot of behind the scenes of what I'm doing right now. You wouldn't believe it. Yeah, you wouldn't believe it. I don't believe it, but y'all would. Man, I hope y'all had a good, whenever you're watching this video, I hope you had a good day or a good evening. Wherever you at, if you're over in Texas, I hope that dang storm didn't cause too much damage for y'all. You know, we're still getting rain from it. The leftovers. The feeder bands from it. Don't want any more hurricanes. Small ones, I don't mind. Category 1 or 2, that's fine. They don't worry me, but I don't want no more Katrinas ever again. I'm gonna sell my crap and leave. That mess happened again. That sucked. After all this time. I hated that damn storm. Oh, what's going on? I hear, let me know what is happening where y'all are. I know here in Gulfport and Biloxi, the alcohol sales have been banned past 11 o'clock. I don't know what, I guess that's to stop people from being at a bar. I don't know. I don't know why they did that. Let me know what you think why they did that. A lot of things going on, I just don't know what's happening because they don't tell me. Between 11 p.m. and 7 a.m., I think is the ban, but who the hell want to buy some damn beer at 7, before 7, at 6:30 in the morning anyway? I don't know. I don't know if that applies to bars, just bars or restaurants or stores or casinos or whatnot, because nobody tells me nothing. Nobody tells nobody nothing. Oh, look at that. That golden brown pretty. Now, since I've never cooked these before, I am going to call that done. And if it's still raw in the middle, I ain't gonna eat it. You know what? I don't know if that's done or not. That scares me because I want to eat these things. Look, I'm gonna put them back in just a little bit more. Ain't nothing like experimenting while you're cooking some food. I don't want to overcook it, and I don't want to undercook it. And it'd been smart, maybe if I'd have looked up on the internet how long it took these things, I'd have probably knew what I was doing, but that ain't no fun. They don't come out right, I'll cut them up and give them to the cat. Speaking of cats, my baby birds left when I was on, took my little vacation. I come back and they was gone. It was about 10 days old. 10 or 11 days old. I come back, the nest was empty. So I don't know if they went ahead and left on their own, or a crow got them, or a cat got them, or a possum got them, or a mouse got them, or a rat got them. Because I definitely got everything that I just mentioned around. I got them around here. See, this is what kills me. Now I'm getting, losing my patience because that's smelling good. I'm ready to eat. Good doggy, man. Oh, GoPro getting cooked from that heat. We'll put that yonder. And let's throw in a piece. No, we ain't throwing in. We're going to gently, when I say gently, place the catfish in there. Gently put it in there. I don't mess around with no hot air. It'll burn you up. Whew, poor GoPro hot. GoPro Hero 5 Black. This has been a good little camera. That red's wicked out from good too. And I don't know, but if there's any background noise from me holding up this GoPro or holding down the GoPro, I do apologize, but I'd rather have a little background noise than that GoPro falling that hot Earl. Hungry already. All right, we're gonna go. Y'all have a good evening, good morning, good afternoon, good whatever, whenever. Get outside, have some fun. If you can't go outside, stay inside and cook some damn food. Don't let the news bring you down. They will certainly try to do it, and they'll do it just to get them ratings. Talk about the bad things all the time. All right, we'll take a picture of this whole mess when it's all said and done for, and done with, and done did. Y'all take care. Thanks for watching. Peace to you. Tighten up. Hey, is that a bug in there? No!